something written, but I think it's just all scribble, so I just, basically, my background is journalism. It's my profession, and it's my love. It's my first love, and it's still my love. And when I started my career, it was it's so it's really fun about the world is happening. Basically experimented on that a few years ago when I was living in France because I was feeling kind of isolated, you know, being in a foreign country and missing a lot of things back home. But mostly it was because I was also thinking a lot of, well, it's kind of a long story, but I was focusing too much on where I spent part of my childhood in Holon and also in Sambuanga. And I had done a little bit of research on the rebellion at that time. And I wanted to come back again. I wanted to go back to go and just continue writing a story and doing research. So when I did that, I had a little bit prepared some materials for me when I was in France, so I started writing on Sambuanga. About two princesses at the end of the era, and the other one was the burning of the rocks. And that was very crucial for me because when I was growing up in Sambuanga, nobody talked about it in school, so we didn't read about it in books. It was as if the place, the whole place didn't exist. Sambu was like an island of, everything in the world would go there, it's nothing. And, for me, it was an odd thing because I lived in Palanca and it wasn't like that. So I was trying to come to terms with that, some kind of emotions, and decided to write the book. Again, it's a long story. I'd rather, maybe later on, if you have other questions on that. But I think what's interesting for me now is living with writers because I can play with those things. I can play with creative writing and journalism. I was just thinking a while ago, when I got to the taxi, the play that, and Nika said, don't take the taxi because it's a walk exposure. My first instinct was to call my friend and ask, is it the fair, is it bad, how many will kill? And I wanted to go there rather than coming. It's just to find out what is really happening. So it's that, it's still there. And I wanted to explore that, but at the same time, and it's fun because basically, for me, journalism is going after the story, looking for the story, getting the facts. But creative writing is more like the story coming to me. So I wanted to explore both things. One book that I just finished, which is going to come out next month, is like a journey from Sulu to now. Normally a journalist will go in there to do research and find out where to go and who to talk to and things like that. I didn't do that. I just got in the plane and just go where I had to go. And just waited for what, I would come across and whatever would surprise me. And I would do this with journalists. It's like I wanted the story to come to me first. And then be a journalist at once and provide that. So it was fun. It's really a lot of fun for me because in the end it turned out also like a journey. And in any case, each book, each story that we write has its meaning, obviously. Each book that we do has a reason for why we were at a certain time in our lives, I think. When I started writing creative nonfiction and very journalism. Like I said, I was in France, I was feeling through that, the journalist side of me comes up and says, hey, what's next? There's not what's the most important thing. Anyway, I'm tired. I'm interested, so I'm hoping to